Marine biologists on board tell us time is of the essence here. They're taking off right now and they'll spend the day conducting water samples and other sediment and fish samples from around Tampa Bay. What they're hoping to do is track where exactly the wastewater has gone and then run tests on it to better understand the scope and scale of its impacts on our water. The big concern, of course, with this type of water is the potential that it could spark harmful algae blooms. It's because the wastewater from Piney Point's abandoned fertilizer plant contains phosphates and nitrogen, and those are the nutrients that algae feeds on. An overgrowth of algae blooms can lead to red tide, which of course can have devastating ripple effects on marine life. So marine scientists on board are going to be looking for potentially toxic effects in our bay.
One of the things that's super important is to figure out, because the discharge water is relatively high in nutrients, and you want to know where it's going and where it might end up, because ultimately if you have a high concentration of nutrients in the water column, that certainly could stimulate phytoplankton growth, and red tide is one type, obviously, of phytoplankton. So their sampling will extend offshore to help make that linkage if in fact there is one.
Millions of gallons of Piney Point wastewater continues to be released into Tampa Bay each day, but state officials say they're releasing it in a way that's hopefully going to minimize the environmental impact. The Department of Environmental Protection says the water is not radioactive and meets all water quality standards for marine waters, with the exception of pH, total phosphorus, total nitrogen, and total ammonia nitrogen. The department also says it is slightly acidic. USF scientists say they'll be conducting their own tests on the bay water to help support the department. They'll also have the results from some of those tests immediately. Things like pH levels they can find out today, but scientists say most of their tests will take weeks, if not months, to come back with results. In St. Petersburg, Kelly Cowan, Fox 13 News.